Hello everyone, it's Wilfred here, and I hope your day has been amazing. I've had the Pixel 6 for a while now, and it's been a great treat. A real great treat. Well, this is aside from the previous bug frenzy that eats the Pixel 6 lineup. Well, without slowing the sands of time, let's dive directly into this device. I can say for a fact that the Pixel 6, with its spanking 6.4-inch 90Hz display, its beautiful body sandwich with Gorilla Victus on the front and Gorilla Glass 6 on the back, with an all-lovely dual-tone design, makes the Pixel 6 a joy to hold and to use. The device feels satisfying, and the simplistic approach to its design makes it one of the most functional Pixels ever launched. So if you ask me, I'll say it's simplistic, yet feels like a luxury device. The horizontal camera strip is also a refreshing touch and sets the Pixel 6 lineup apart from the ever dull competition of camera bumps out there. It's a bold statement by Google, a really bold one. They say can't be said about the unboxing of the device though, as only a USB-C cable, a SIM ejector, and thankfully USB-A to USB-C adapter is in the box. At least, this is better than most flagship out there. Man, the days of good unboxing has ended. Now it's unboxing Ragnarok. Now, moving on, talking about the display. The always-on 6.4-inch AMOLED display isn't a spec monster, really. Nor is it a slacker. It sits in the region of being beautifully capable. I particularly like the stellar flat nature of the device, the display. Call me Asian, but I do have a preference for flat displays. The refresh rate is okay, and I don't actually feel the difference when compared to 120Hz refresh in isolation. It's just okay and competent. Its 1080 by 2400 resolution results in a 411 ppi and holds a 20 by 9 aspect ratio. And this screen is certified for HDR10+, which means you can watch your favorite videos on any of the platforms that already support HDR10, like YouTube and Netflix. The screen is bright enough to be used even in direct sunlight, as I tried with its ambient pushed 800 plus nits brightness. But I did observe though that the auto brightness thing isn't as good as other devices I've used in the past. It's fixable with software, considering many users have reported similar things. So it's a bug Google need to really work on. Now moving on to the battery life and the charging of this phone. The phone packs a 4,614 mAh battery. The Pixel performed well in battery life, although less than what I initially expected when I heard Google was creating their own chipsets, but still great. I guess I've been spoiled by my time using an iPhone 13 Pro Max, which is in fact the beast battery champ right now. On the Pixel, I easily got 8 to 10 hours of significant misused. If you restrict the device display to 60Hz, you can see better results and better numbers actually. I think it's worth noting that the charging speed on this device is nothing particularly stellar. Having handled the devices that do full charges in under an hour, I'm not really impressed by the almost 2 hour long time it takes to juice up the Pixel 6. It also supports wireless and reverse charging. Now, let's move on and talk about the Tensor Chip and using the device. I was wowed when I saw the hype surrounding the Google Pixel 6 and its custom 5nm Google Tensor Chip. I wanted to see how Google will play their game. Well, the Tensor Chip isn't the best chip out in the wild, but I can confidently say Google did a fine job. It appeared they wanted the best AI-capable smartphone chipset in the market. Oh boy, did they accomplish this. Using the device feels snappy, and the cleanness of stock Android 12 is really refreshing. And that's all thanks to Material U, which amazed. For those who like numbers, well, on Antutu, I got roughly 678,000 rating. Honestly, the phone is fast, and this worked nicely as they should. When it comes to the under-display fingerprint, I can boldly say I've seen faster devices in my period of using smartphones. Even the one found on the ancient OnePlus 8 Pro appears faster than the Pixel 6. Samsung really blows it out of the water in speed when compared to previous X21 or even the S22 Ultra, which I have in the studio right now. However, in isolation, the sensor on the Pixel 6 are okay. The speakers are nice and crisp and loud as well. The mics are super reliable. The camera on this device are great. A video dedicated to the camera strip and the superb 50 megapixel primary sensor and the pretty much sweet 12 megapixel ultra-wide camera unit will be out in a separate video. That aside, the few shots I've had on the device were really astonishing. It essentially produces high quality level photos and videos like those on its more expensive pro sibling, the Google Pixel 6 Pro. The front-facing camera is an 8 megapixel sensor and produces okay to great selfies and videos depending on the lighting. I will want you to kindly watch out for the full camera dedicated video that will be coming out soon. So if you're not subscribed, please be subscribed to this channel. Now, hands down, I can confidently say the Pixel 6 is the world's smartest device. And this, my friend, is the jewel of the Pixel 6 lineup. The Tensor Chip is a groundbreaker, and this is seen in its implementation of machine learning models and high, never before seen levels of natural language processing on a mobile device. And this is seen in the Recorder app, which packs a super speech-to-text model that is very accurate and progressively smart. The transcript done on this device is world-chattering and impossible to outrun. Well, other AI and NLP jewels include live caption, live translate, and some other functionalities that are in the device, especially the host of computational photography and videography. The Pixel 6 is a jewel. A video touching on how the Pixel 6 is the smartest smartphone ever launched will be out later, so kindly subscribe so you don't miss that. And this feat is all thanks to the insane numbers of hours spent developing these machine learning models and building a custom chip. So at $599, the Pixel 6 is a no-brainer for me. It defines what a mid-entry device is and blows the water into the territory of the ever expensive phones out there. It's a no-brainer for me. It's a serious no-brainer for me. And I like the fact that Google has developed its own chipset for this device. It shows that they are serious about mobile devices hardware right now, and they are channeling all their power to create a quite vertical integration of their ecosystem. So that has been the review of the Google Pixel 6. Google has found its rhythm with this device, and I hope this device and what it stands for continues. Don't forget to use the comment section, smash the like button if you like this review, and subscribe if you've not already subscribed. So stay awesome and stay pixelicious.